Yes, but the main idea here is that 2,000 years ago, our sages wrote this book, or wrote a commentary called the Midrash. And there's one in particular called the Midrash Yalkut Shimoni. Allegorical, I guess, allusions, not illusions, but allusions. Commentary on the Torah. Things that allude, commentaries that allude to something. Prophecies, basically. So one's called Midrash Yalkut Shimoni, commentary on, I believe it's Isaiah, if I'm not mistaken, Yeshaya. And it talks about, it says the following. Persia will agitate the entire world, and Arabia will come to counsel, like to come to get advice from Edom, and then Persia will like get to a point, I'm just paraphrasing, where they will, you know, have the knife on the world's throat, and every single nation will, everybody will agitate each other, everybody will saber rattle from each other, and then the Jewish people will say, oh my God, you know, like, we're going to fall on our faces and say, what are we going to do? What are we going to do? And then Hashem, and then a voice will call out, and it'll say to the Jewish people, don't worry, the time of your redemption has arrived. So my friends, my question to you, this was written 2,000 years ago. Just a historical question. Who the hell were the Arabs 2,000 years ago? Persia was kind of a declining, maybe even non-existent empire. It wasn't an empire anymore at that time. During the time of the Romans. Persia. And Edom, you could say, is Rome. But again, guys, Persia agitating the world, Arabia taking counsel, the Arabs taking counsel with the Romans. Folks, all I gotta say is somebody saw something. Somebody saw something 2,000 years ago, and they wrote about it. And they said this is what would be happening right before the Geulah, right before the redemption, right before the Mashiach. I mean, my friends, I don't know about you. Have you ever seen a moment like this? I mean, they already sent these ballistic missiles. I was there in Israel in April. They were over my head. I was staying 10 minutes away from, you know, from the old city. 5 minutes away from the entrance of the old city, 10 minutes away from Har Habayis, from Temple Mount. These missiles were right over the Temple Mount. It was a giant explosion. I thought it was a firecracker, but it wasn't. So I was used to the firecrackers of Ramadan, you know, every day for 40 days. And now, my friends, they're threatening something even worse. You know? And they're saying it's not going to be one time, it's going to be like 2 or 3 days in a row, maybe even more. Now they're saying these, like, Israelis, like citizens, are preparing, the government and the army, they're preparing bunkers for themselves, you know, to just in case the government has to go, people in the government have to go, like, you know, incognito and be able to communicate. Citizens are preparing for all kinds of scenarios, you know, no, having no power for 3 days, people having to go to the center, you know, to the Jerusalem and Tel Aviv. My friends, this sounds to me like Midrash Yalkut Shimoni. That's what this sounds like to me. Today Iran said, you know, they tried to do a mediation with them, with the Arab countries, and I think the Biden administration, maybe, And Iran, the Iranian regime basically said, we don't care if this starts a war. We don't mind. It doesn't bother us. My friends. Paras, Persia, is agitating the entire world. And the Arabs are coming to council with Edom. And they're trying to talk to Persia. Maybe that was the only thing that was omitted, that they were trying to talk to Persia. But they're taking counsel with Edom. They're taking counsel with those guys. So that's basically the story. We are right now at the moment, and I just want to say one more thing, guys. I'm going to try to put it in a way that's... How should I put this? You know, it's Rosh Chodesh Av right now. Chodesh Tov. And, they say not to... I mean, we're not supposed to inflame animosity and arguments with our fellow Jews. So, but especially this week, these 9 days, right? So, I'm going to say like this. My friends, my fellow Torah Jews, people in the Orthodox community. You know, I didn't grow up Orthodox. But I just gotta tell you, you know, sometimes I get the feeling that a lot of people in the community, especially people who grew up Orthodox, you know, maybe they forget that the Torah is, certain parts of the Torah, let's say, is real. That there's no possible way, huh? There's a couple of deer here. That there's no possible way that, oh wow, it's a whole family. Goodness gracious. Uh-oh. Ladies and gentlemen. I'm surrounded by a family of deer. One second. Eretz Tzvi. The thing is, they have horns. So I better move quickly. I've infiltrated their space. One sec, guys. Steer hanging out. Okay. Cool. Alright. Anyway, guys. So. Sorry. I've never seen so many deer in this neighborhood simultaneously. I've seen maybe one or two. Not a whole family. Alright. So. I guess it's a sign. Time to go back to Israel. So I just want to say, guys, you know, the Torah is real. The Torah is very real. Every part of the Torah is real, including some so-called obscure midrash, obscure commentary from 2,000 years ago. And here we are. Paras is agitating the world. And Arabia. Who the hell were Arabia? Again, taking counsel with Edom, with America and Europe. And the time of the redemption has arrived. Alright, my friends. Horoscope.